And my dream had always been to write. Well, it had always been to be a veterinarian, but that was never going to happen. So I thought, well, I'll just see if I can get published. Meanwhile, my mom started dating one of my art teachers. So gross. So I started writing this book about a girl whose mom was dating one of her teachers. And I thought, you know what, this might be a good book and maybe I could get it published. And my agent said, you know, it might be a good YA. And I was like, yeah, nobody dies, so no, it won't. And she said, no, YA's changed. You should go to the bookstore and check it out. So I did. And I found some actually funny YAs, like Sharon Creech's Absolutely Normal Chaos, and Kevin Cushman's Kevin Colbert-y. I wrote down a bunch of them, but I forget them now. But they were really funny. And Making Out series by Catherine Applegate. Not funny, but whatever. Hot. If I had found that, like, when I had gone to the YA section, I wouldn't have fled. But nobody gets game rich. So, okay. So I thought, okay, well, maybe this will work. So, but the problem was that she said, I don't think that the thing with the girl just having her mom date her teacher is enough of a story. Can you do something more to it? And I was like, well, I always wanted to be a princess. So maybe I'll just have her turn out to be a princess. And she was like, okay. So I put that in. And blah, blah, blah. Everyone rejected it, except for this one girl. And it became The Princess Diaries, and it became a movie. And I can talk about that if you want, but it's really long. And did you know Whitney Houston optioned it? That was Whitney Houston, pre-crack. I know. Nobody knows that. She's so cute. So what happened was, all these girls went to see that movie. And it was rated G. The book has like French kissing condoms and stuff in it. And they would buy the book, and then it was too old for them. And their parents were writing these really mean letters. So I thought, I need to write a book that's more age appropriate for the viewers of the Princess Diaries movies, so their parents stop writing me these mean letters. So I did. It's called Allie Finkel's Rules for Girls. It's actually age appropriate for the viewers of The Princess Diaries. Yeah. It's about a girl who was just like me, who wanted to be a veterinarian and had two little brothers and lived in this funky little town. I took out the stuff about the family life that was unsatisfactory. But everything else is totally accurate. Except for the fact that she is good at math and science. I was like, live the dream. Yeah, why not? It's fiction. Awesome. Oh, it's so funny, though, because little girls interview you when you, I didn't know this, but when you write from middle grade, they have little girls actually interview you. And so I'm like, she's just like you. Are you good at math and science? And I'm like, yeah. But it actually turns out I am. Like, when I worked at NYU, I was in charge of payroll. And when a guy named Julio is really mad because you didn't do his paycheck right, you learn to do math. I know, I can do it now. I can do like algorithms and stuff because when your ass is gonna be kicked by a janitor, you learn. I think they should teach fourth grade math that way. Have Julio teach it. That's the problem with math in America. Make Julio teach it, I don't know. Okay, so really what I wanna say is I'm glad that I didn't become a veterinarian.